102.5 WBXO Classic Rock Redefined, a special edition of the Pat Show. Having sold more than 30 million albums and 18 million digital single sales and 12 iconic hits combined, it's time to jump aboard as the band's Three Doors Down and Collective Soul and special guest Soul Asylum all invite you to join them on their Rock and Roll Express Tour, which is making stops here in the tri-state area this week. These hitmakers will bring three decades of song with them on every stop, and you'll be able to sing every song. Such an honor to have with us on the phone, Three Doors Down guitarist Chris Henderson. Hey, Chris, thanks for your time.
Yeah, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Hey, bud, we last spoke just after the release of your great album, Us in the Night, of which I still play tracks on my radio show. Really love the track In the Dark and, of course, the cool video. First, let me ask you, Chris, how's the tour going? And how did you guys come up with the idea of joining forces with this incredible band out of Georgia called Collective Soul, which I think is a really awesome fit for you both?
Well, the tour's going really well. No complaints at all. Everything's been, you know, all the bands get along really great. The shows have been great. The venue's been great. Everyone's really been really good. And how we came about was we played a show with Collective Soul a long time ago in Wyoming and had a chance to sit and talk to them after the show. And, you know, we decided then that we should try to put something together that would be a good tour. And then, of course, management and all kinds of ideas had to get involved in that. So it took another, you know, couple of years to get it all put together, but we finally did. And thanks to them and thanks to us and thanks to management and the Live Nation, they finally got it put together. So it's been pretty cool.
Excellent. And I know you guys are doing VIP packages, and I encourage all the listeners to go to threedoorsdown.com or Live Nation and get a chance to get a picture and get great seats and meet Chris and Brad and the guys, which is always a good thing. I remember when you guys were thinking, I remember you did it, I want to say a long time ago, when you had the seats on the side of the stage, right?
Yeah, we still have that.
Oh, okay, cool. Well, that's cool. I always thought that was a great idea.
You get a chance to hear the show like we do, like the band does. They actually give you a mix, give you earplugs and a mix that you put in your ears, and you hear exactly what we hear when we're playing. It's pretty cool.
Nice. Well, that's great to know that you're still doing it. I got to say, I've seen you guys a bunch of times. There's nothing better than seeing our great United States flag on a stage on your right side. And I know you're a Navy veteran. I thank you for your service. Besides the love for the country, why is it important for you to display our great flag at each show?
Well, I think that it's important. I mean, it's in my core beliefs. You know what I mean? From being a child, and you know, I see it getting smashed across the world and across the United States. And you know what? If I have a chance to display my patriotism, even for an hour and a half a night or 2 hours a night, I'm going to do it because number one, my right, and number two, I believe it to my bone.
Amen to that, brother.
That is.
Amen to that. And speaking of our great country, you and the band were certainly invited to play at the President pre-inaugural, and I will say the band took a little bit of a beating publicly for it in my opinion, from some morons, to be honest with you. To me, I don't care what president it is or who likes what. This is history in the making, and having the opportunity to perform at such an incredible event, you know, is second to none. Would you agree to that? And what was it like to see that crowd?
Oh, it was absolutely unbelievable. You know, for us, we don't really care what anybody cares about us, honestly. Like, I don't care, personally. And as a band, we don't care. If people don't like it, well, I mean, it really doesn't affect us. People that don't like us now, they don't like us then either.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, it's all good. But the inauguration, to be able to play that, and like you said, to be able to play a piece of history, and to be after that was an incredible honor. And we didn't even think about it. You know what I mean? Matter of fact, we'd already made our decision for the evening after. And we were going to do it no matter what, because that's what you're supposed to do. The country calls you go. You know what I mean? That's what you do. You don't put politics in it. You don't put your personal feelings in it. You go do what you're supposed to do. And that's what we did.
I mean, it shakes my head to read some of the comments, but as you said, these people, either they support you or they don't support you. They're just out of the loop, man. They don't get it. I know the band has played many festivals. Was that, what would you say, was that the biggest gig you ever performed or close to it?
It was close. We played some big ones, You know, there was enough people there, that's a fucking crap, man. There was more people than you could shake a stick in. You didn't see any background from where I was standing. I was there, you know what I'm saying? But if it wasn't the biggest crowd we've ever stood in front of, it was right there with it. And talk about time, we did 200. Go ahead. No, go ahead, finish up, I'm sorry.
I said, I know for a fact we did over 100,000 people in Germany, so there was at least 100,000 people there for me. It doesn't get any better than that, and it really helped promote your album. I mean, Us in the Dark, you know, people really that didn't know you, which I, in my surprise, but it really helped with the record as well.
Yeah, we had a number one record the next day.
Yeah, I mean, what artist and band would want to do that? I shake my head. Any new music in the future, Chris?
Yeah, we're working on some new stuff now. I mean, we're not, obviously not doing it on the road, because it will tend to be about the road, but we've already done all that. We're going to go home after the tour and get back to work. You know, you'll get some new music pretty soon.
Cool. Looking forward to it, because I can certainly play it. Do you prefer to work together as a group in a studio like the old days, or do you guys send WAV files back and forth, or do you do both?
Yeah, we do both. I prefer to work as a group personally, but you know, we do it both ways.
Cool. And I know you're a workout beast, you and Justin, that whole CrossFit, exercise, eating healthy. You guys are partners in crime. It's great to watch you guys do what you do. You definitely, I'm sure you keep each other motivated, right?
Absolutely. I'm trying to keep up with it. He's younger than I am, so I gotta go hard.
We love Justin. He's a great guy, and I love his leather products, and we try to do everything that we can do to help promote him and his products there. I gotta say, I love your Instagram post the other day. Sometimes you have to reflect on a journey. It's a long game. It's not a 21-day fix or powder or pill. It's education, consistency, hard work, failure, and success all at the same time. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. Just try to learn from them. Right on, my man. Great piece of advice. Words that can apply to anything we do.
I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
It's great. Hey, before I let you go, you guys are still doing that great charity, the Better Life Foundation, right? I mean, that's a great thing that you guys do. Can you?
We're doing it in October this year in Cherokee, North Carolina.
Excellent. And just for the fans to know, Chris and the guys started his Better Life Foundation in 2003 with a goal in mind to give as many children as possible a better life. And since its inception, has supported numerous charities across the USA, including the Center for Prevention of Child Abuse and the Habitat for Humanity, and providing aid and assistance to the Gulf Coast region of Mississippi during Hurricane Katrina. And Brad stated in 2006 that you guys have raised approximately $900,000. So congratulations and great job on that.
Thank you very much.
Any other projects that we can help, that you're working on, Chris, that we can help promote you with?
That's it right now. I mean, the tour and the Better Life Foundation, and that's our main focus.
Excellent. Well, nothing but love and respect for you and this band. Been always a strong supporter of our United States Armed Forces, and I know you as a veteran. Again, personally thank you, and thank you for never forgetting the men and women out there on the front lines protecting our freedom each and every day. Having my dad, who was a Purple Heart recipient in World War II, you know, it means that much more to me and my family on the effort that you guys do in promoting our country and our flag, and certainly thank you.
Well, you're very welcome. That's the least we can do for everything that they've done for us. We know that they're not doing it for the money. I mean, I know firsthand they're not doing it for the money. So they're doing it for God and country, and that's what it's all about.
Absolutely, Chris. Thank you. Catch Chris and this Rock and Roll Express Tour as it arrives tonight in New Hampshire, New Jersey tomorrow, Long Island next Tuesday. I'm going to be at Mohegan Sun on Thursday, Niagara Falls next Saturday, and Atlantic City next Sunday. To check out where this great band is going, I encourage you to go to the Three Doors Down website at threedoorsdown.com. Chris, I hope you enjoyed the chat as much as I did, my friend.
I certainly did, and I appreciate it once again.
All right, my man. Safe travels, and hope to see you at Mohegan Sun. We can say hello. I need to get one of those Trump guitar picks from my killer collection, buddy.
Hey, you know what? I can hook that up.
I know you can. I'm looking forward to it. Thank you again. Chris Henderson, Three Doors Down, on the Pat Show. Time to play some of the great music. And one of my favorites is called In the Dark. Thanks, Chris.
Thank you.